Hello. I am pleased and grateful to welcome you to ABC's virtual celebration and Botanical Excellence Awards ceremony. If we haven't met yet, please allow me to introduce myself. I'm Mark Blumenthal, founder and executive director of the nonprofit American Botanical Council. During the next 45 minutes or so, you will have the opportunity to meet other members of ABC, both the staff and Board of Trustees. However, due to the limited time we have today, I lament that we cannot include everyone here at ABC. There are two primary reasons why ABC created this annual celebration. The first is to thank all the sponsor members who support ABC and our unique nonprofit research and educational mission and our programs and our publications through their generous support through membership and donations. The second reason for this celebration is as a vehicle to call attention to some of the great research and educational work that many of our friends and colleagues are doing around the world. More about that in a few minutes. This is an event that ABC has held 14 times in the past 15 years, always on the opening night of Natural Products Expo West in Anaheim, California in the first week of March. Obviously and lamentably, last year Expo West and the ABC celebration was canceled due to the COVID pandemic. This event is different from the previous years in two ways. First of all, obviously, it's virtual. And second, while our live event usually had about 350 people in attendance, mostly people in the herb and natural products industry who were there in Anaheim for commercial and professional purposes, because this year the event is virtual, we have decided to invite all ABC members, including ABC members who are scientists, educators, health professionals, everybody, wherever you live in the world, in the 80 countries that ABC has membership. So I offer this welcome, this special welcome, to you if this is your first time at an ABC celebration.
Hi, this is Greg Riss of Indina, and I wanted to give a big shout out to the Herbal Cowboy and his amazing staff at ABC in Austin. Obviously, rumors of you riding off into the sunset have been greatly exaggerated, but that's great news for us. Mark, thank you for your 33 years of leadership and service to the botanical industry. It's greatly appreciated. And since we're both Roger McGuinn fans, I thought I'd leave you with this. Because clearly, Marco, you were so much older then. You're younger than that now. Cheers, amigo.
You know, we're all aware that for all of us, 2020 was a very difficult, unprecedented, and challenging year. Fortunately for ABC, we were able to focus on the health of our employees first and their families, and the health of ABC as an organization, to maintain our organizational and financial integrity and our mission. We also focused on our core mission to the point where we ensured that we could continue disseminating accurate, responsible, reliable information on herbs and medicinal plants. We were able to publish all of our usual publications, HerbalGram, HerbalEGram, HerbClip, Herbal News and Events, and the publications from the Botanical Adulterants Prevention Program and the Sustainable Herbs Program. We even increased the number of herbs that companies have adopted on the ABC HerbMed Pro website. And we added more value to ABC's membership by providing, so far, 17 webinars for free to all our members and the entire herbal community. Webinars covering the compelling subjects related to sustainability and ethnobotany. We are super grateful for our ability to have made it through this pandemic and into 2021.
Hello. Thank you to all of our esteemed guests and congratulations to the awardees. Every year, ABC bestows the James A. Duke Excellence in Botanical Literature Award to works that contribute significantly to the medicinal plant-related literature. The Duke Award was created in 2006 to honor Jim Duke, the noted economic botanist, ABC co-founder, and author. Duke's prestigious career included decades of work with the United States Department of Agriculture and the authorship of more than 30 reference and consumer books. This year, ABC has given the Duke Award to Christopher Hobbs for his work, Christopher Hobbs's Medicinal Mushrooms, The Essential Guide, published by Story Publishing. Hobbs's work was chosen for its consumer-friendly approach to the field of mycology, with scientific and clinical research presented in a creative and informative way and featuring beautiful photography throughout. Hobbs is a fourth-generation botanist, an herbalist, a research scientist, and an author of more than 20 books. He holds a PhD in phylogenetics, evolutionary biology, and phytochemistry from the University of California, Berkeley, and has studied medicinal fungi since the 1970s. Much of the cultural and historical information presented in this book came from his 8,000-volume library. In Medicinal Mushrooms, he strives to answer the question of how fungi affect and promote human health and studies the ancient interaction between fungi and humans. Like Jim Duke, Christopher Hobbs blends a love of plants with an inquisitive nature and supports tradition with science in a clear, concise, and passionate way. He has succeeded in creating an accessible book for readers at every level of interest. Features of the book include practical instructions and recipes for medicinal preparations and a guide to growing mushrooms at home. It also contains a comprehensive and responsible overview of the controversial subject of psychoactive and hallucinogenic mushrooms, as well as the future possibilities that these visionary fungi contain. Congratulations to Christopher Hobbs and Christopher Hobbs's Medicinal Mushrooms, The Essential Guide, the awardee of the 2020 James A. Duke Excellence in Botanical Literature Award.
First of all, I want to thank my friend Mark Blumenthal and all the ABC staff for this wonderful honor, the James A. Duke Excellence in Botanical Literature Award. I know I'm in great company, first of all with Jim, all his incredible books, songs, teachings, which inspired so many, including me. Secondly, with all the other researchers and writers who were recipients of this award, I am in truly excellent company indeed. Thanks to Story Publications, especially my editor, Carlene Madigan. Their design work, meticulous rounds of editing, and the willingness to pull out all the stops to create such a high-quality book to hold really blew me away. Thanks to George Vaughn for his years of experience as a mushroom grower. He contributed to the mushroom growing section. Thanks to Far West Fungi for their generous bounty of gorgeous fresh mushrooms that are featured throughout the book. Much appreciation to Ty Power Seif, our super photographer, as such a beautiful artist, and her photographs are featured throughout the book. This book is many years in the making, and I first wrote my first pamphlet on medicinal mushrooms in 1986, and then the second edition in 1995, and finally this edition, which is all new writing, though it does really include a lot of my years of experience in growing, eating, collecting mushrooms, studying mushrooms, and absorbing the scientific literature, which has grown voluminously over the last number of years. I wanted to make this book a practical guide with featuring medicine making, growing, choosing commercial products, and the importance of quality, combining the folklore and traditional uses with a thorough review of the scientific literature, and especially all clinical trials available for each species. I hope it can inspire a love of mushrooms and the preservation of their habitats, especially the old growth forests and trees of which they are an integral part, and especially the old growths. Again, it is so delightful to receive this award. It really touches my heart. Thanks again.
Hi everyone, I'm Jim Emmy. I'm CEO of Now Foods. And we're pleased to say that we're continue to be a supporter of the American Botanical Council. ABC provides so much great science-based information to consumers the worldwide, and to help them better understand the available botanicals and the possibilities these plant-based materials can have in helping them meet their health goals. Thank you, Mark, and all the ABC team for everything you do each and every day of the year.
Greetings from Noblesville, Indiana. I'm Ajay Patel, founder and CEO of Vidura Sciences. I want to thank Mark and ABC for the opportunity to sponsor this year's ABC Celebration and Awards. I would like to congratulate all of the winners of this prestigious award. As a botanical ingredients company, we're extremely grateful and thankful for the dedication, the hard work that Mark and ABC have put in over several decades to ensure the traceability, the quality, the sustainability, and safety of this category. So thank you, Mark, and for you, and only for you, today I'm wearing this shirt.
During the past 10 years, Adopt an Herb has allowed a company to underwrite ABC's cost in compiling, editing, and including new information, new clinical and new scientific research about a specific herb that's adopted into the extensive and powerful HerbMed Pro database. Adoptions are a public recognition opportunity for companies. ABC puts this information on their website. We put this information in HerbalGram and other ABC media properties. We acknowledge the generosity and the support of the adopting company in relation to its corresponding adopted herb. Companies enjoy this opportunity because it gives them a great deal of public recognition for a relatively modest fee, depending on the amount of research published on that particular herb. Now we're adding videos to this opportunity. A company can actually underwrite the publication and the compilation of a 5 to 8 minute educational video on their adopted herb. We're currently working on milk thistle as our first adopted herb video in May of 2021.
Hello everyone, I'm here bow tie less as per Mark Blumenthal's instructions to introduce Dr. Paula N. Brown as this year's recipient of the Norman R. Farnsworth Award for Excellence in Botanical Research. Paula and Norm met a number of years ago. The two hit it off immediately. I think Norm was impressed by her intellect and by the fact that she, like him, as an academic researcher, had to scramble very hard for grant money in order to do the work and fund her students and her associates in her program. Paula was involved early on in some very controversial issues. She published a landmark paper years ago in the discovery of diethylstilbestrol and warfarin as adulterants in PC spez. She did work developing and running analytical methods for Houdia authentication. She's worked on kratom, cannabidiol, and other marijuana constituents over the years. Paula has also published analytical methods, validated analytical methods for a number of dietary supplement ingredients, including ginseng, echinacea, and many, many others. I think she's got more publications of supplement ingredient methods in the AOAC's official methods of analysis book than any other author that I know. Paula started life as a synthetic organic chemist. She had very little botany or botanical or biological training at all in her various programs, and she forced herself with help from others to become a very competent field biologist. So she's gone slogging through cranberry bogs and hawthorn forests, collecting materials for her studies. It gives me great pleasure to introduce Paula as the recipient of this year's award. Thank you very much.
Wow, just wow. I promised 2 minutes, but it hardly seems like enough time to truly express my gratitude at receiving such an amazing honor from the American Botanical Council. In particular, the award named for the scientist, Dr. Farnsworth, whose tremendous work I greatly admire, and Norman, the man who I appreciated, respected, and very much miss. There are so many amazing people within this eclectic community of botanicals who have inspired, guided, mentored, and supported me throughout my journey. And I just want to acknowledge that it has not been alone, and I know how fortunate I've been, and for that, I thank you all. With the minute I have left, I want to acknowledge a few colleagues without whose support I would not be receiving this award. Joe Betts, my co-champion for better methods to support botanical quality and safety, my favorite co-author and a very dear friend, Roy Upton, whose beautiful work at the American Herbal Pharmacopoeia I've been very fortunate to be able to contribute to for the last couple of decades. Susan Murch, who told me if I want to study plants, I better get out my rain boots and get out there. And she said it maybe a little more colorfully than that. And Wendy Applequist, who patiently supported my journey from lab to field. Stephen Dentali, my advisor in all things nomenclature and whose humor continuously makes me smile. And Mary Hardy, last year's ABC Freddie Cronenberg Award winner, who reminds me as I go down my rabbit hole of chemistry, that this is about health. It's about educating and facilitating the responsible use of botanical medicines for improved health and wellness. And she would also remind me that I'm out of time. So I will end with an acknowledgement that my research is and has always been a team effort. Everything that I've achieved here at BCIT has been with the support, hard work, and dedication of my group, many of which who've been with me for close to 2 decades. And I thank all of them because they are a part of this award as well. My congratulations to all of this year's award recipients. And again, thank you to Mark and the American Botanical Council for this just tremendous honor. Thank you.
My name is Anne Armbrecht, and I'm the director of the Sustainable Herbs Program, which continues to flourish since becoming part of ABC. There's a growing consensus that sustainability is good for business. The challenges facing the herbal supply chain, over-harvesting, depleted soils, climate change, the exodus of workers looking for higher-paying jobs, impact and will continue to impact the supply of botanicals from around the world. One person or company can't tackle these issues alone. The Sustainable Herbs Program is a place where industry professionals are collaborating, researching the issues, and sharing ideas about how to make concrete actions to make a difference on the ground. Our webinar series this past year has reached over 50,000 views. In the toolkit webinars, we're bringing new voices to conversations about responsible sourcing and best practices. And the ethnobotany webinars focus on the crucial role and importance of culture and values in our interactions with the world of plants. Participants in these webinars come from around the world. They include everyone from longtime veterans in the botanical industry to newcomers in that industry, academics, herbalists, and general consumers with an interest in plants. The SHP Regenerative Practices Toolkit, published last year, gathers in one place best practices about sustainability and responsible sourcing for the industry. We're developing this toolkit into a self-guided curriculum that companies can use to educate not just those involved directly in sourcing, but the whole company to really understand the challenges and connections between quality, responsible sourcing, and sustainability. And also, because collaboration is key to the success of any long-term changes, we have also launched a series of brown bag conversations on key issues for SHP underwriters. The first of these discussions focused on authentic storytelling, and the next will include discussions on approaches to conducting risk assessments for sourcing botanicals. The first step to changing a system is seeing and understanding that system from the perspective of the stakeholders involved. And so we've also continued to create educational content directed at a general audience. Our goal in this work is to provide the information needed to create more nuanced conversations so that this community of consumers can better support and encourage more committed action around sustainability by companies. As Bioneer's co-founder Kenny Ozabel writes, "We can't be well until the planet is well." And it continues to be my honor to help lead this initiative, working to show how this principle guides this industry, that the health of natural products is inextricably linked to the health of the human and ecological communities that are part of their production. We thank you so much for your engagement and continued support.
Congratulations, American Botanical Council, and all the award recipients. Thank you, Mark, for being such a great friend and supporter of the industry, building up the credibility for botanicals and educating the world on the safe and effective use of herbals. You're an inspiration, and I look forward to working together. Here's to the continued success of ABC. Cheers.
Greetings, ABC Nation. This is Lauren Israelson checking in, saying hello. I wanted to congratulate Mark and his staff at ABC for the tremendous work they have and continue to do, and also to acknowledge and salute the award winners this year. Well, it's been a tough year. I can't wait till all of us can be back together once again to lift a glass, to share a meal, to give a hug and a kiss. So until that time, I salute all of you, wish you well, and say goodbye for now.
Good evening. My name is Mary Hardy. I would like to thank Mark Blumenthal and ABC for inviting me as last year's winner of the Freddie Cronenberg for Excellence in Botanicals for Women's Health Award to present this year's award. Given the long history of women caring for women, often with little recognition from the larger medical or research communities, I'm especially happy that this award exists. It honors outstanding female scientists and educators, but I think it also marks a sisterhood that most women have not had access to during their training and early careers. Before I go on to mentioning this year's winner, I would like to speak a little bit about Freddie Cronenberg, who exemplifies the values inherent in this award. She was a consummate researcher for natural products and women's health. She also was passionate about herbal education for healthcare providers and ran a course in this area for many years. But more than all that, she had a great sense of humor. an endlessly curious mind. And what was most important to her, she was a great friend. As I have been reminded, we have just passed the 4th anniversary of her death, and she is missed still. Given Freddie's interest, this year's winner, Dr. Tori Hudson, is a uniquely appropriate honoree. Dr. Hudson devoted her 35-plus year career as a naturopath to women's health as a researcher, clinician, and educator. She has had a leading role in educating naturopaths about the primary and specialty natural care of women. First at her alma mater, the Natural College of Natural Medicine in Portland. She now also has appointments at Bastyr and Southwestern as well. She is, in fact, the first female naturopath to ever attain the rank of full professor in a naturopathic school. She has won a number of prestigious awards during her career, including, but not limited to, the ANANP Physician Award for Research, 1999, Naturopathic Physician of the Year, 1999, and in 2012, she was inducted into the NCMN Hall of Fame. She has published broadly, both in the lay professional press on all aspects of women's care, contributed to many textbooks, and published her own books, including Women's Encyclopedia of Natural Health and Gynecology and Natural Medicine. It is with great pleasure that I present to you the 2021 winner of the Freddie Cronenberg Award for Excellence in Botanicals for Women's Health, Dr. Tori Hudson.
Hi, everyone. This award process started for me when Mark Blumenthal left an auspicious message on my home voicemail. An issue has come up and I need to speak with you immediately. That's what it said. I spent days fretting. What could I have possibly done to upset Mark Blumenthal? In pure Mark style, however, it was his relentless, obviously joking spirit that was at play. But I'm still pondering my comedic vengeance, Mark, so beware. You know, I first met Freddie Cronenberg in the earliest days of the development of the Office of Complementary and Alternative Medicine at the National Institutes of Health, which then became and is currently called the National Center for Complementary and Integrative Health. At these meetings, Freddie was incredibly kind, inclusive, and collaborative towards me and others, and she was innovative, intellectually impressive, and consistently productive in her research and academic activities, especially in regards to botanicals, integrative medicine, and women's health, three pillars of my professional and clinical career as well. I'm truly grateful to those who came before me as recipients of this award, Drs. T. Roni Lodog, Aviva Rahm, and Mary Hardy. These three women physicians have paved incredible, formidable path in women's health, integrative medicine, and botanical medicine. And I really thank them and am touched that they have included me in their professional coven of sorts by acknowledging me as the recipient of this 2021 Freddie Cronenberg Excellence in Research and Education in Botanicals for Women's Health Award from our friends at the American Botanical Council. So thank you so much, Tironi, Aviva, Mary, Mark, and all the incredibly hardworking folks at the American Botanical Council. And thank you, Freddie, for befriending me and letting me learn from you and alongside you, even though it was for far too short a time. Thank you again all for this award, and may the plants be with you, and may the plants be with us all for a very, very, very long time.
Medicinal plants have been and are the main source and inspiration for people's health and medical discovery. EuroMed produces plant extracts since 1971. People rely always more on complementary medicine, and the ABC has a leading role to keep the industry transparent while providing great opportunities for communication and marketing. EuroMed is a proud supporter of the ABC not-for-profit project, so I personally, as a friend and in the name of EuroMed, wish a virtual, memorable, and green celebration.
Thank you, American Botanical Council and Mark Blumenthal, for all that you do for this wonderful community. From HerbalGram to the Botanical Adulterants Prevention Program, Sustainable Herb Project, many, many things, even making sure that Hawaiian shirts stay in style, which I can't thank you enough for. But seriously, where would we be without the American Botanical Council? I know I would not be where I am today. Our business would not be where it is today, so thank you. Also want to say congratulations to today's award winners and thank you for all you do to make this a better world. And finally, I just cannot wait to see you all again in person, particularly you, Herbal Cowboy. I'll see you soon.
It's hard to believe, but the ABC, AHP, and CNPR Botanical Adulterants Prevention Program, or BAP, completed its 10th year of research and education about botanical ingredient adulteration earlier this year. We have two wonderful partners in the American Herbal Pharmacopeia, an independent organization that produces high-quality monographs on botanicals, and the National Center for Natural Products Research at the University of Mississippi. To date, PAP has published 65 peer-reviewed documents, with two more coming out in the next days or weeks. All BAP publications are available for free on the BAP homepage, which you find on the ABC website. Having them accessible to everyone is only possible because of the generous support of our over 200 BAP underwriters. While I would like to thank all of them in this video, Mark told me to be done in 3 minutes, so I have to leave it at that. I also wanted to give a shout out to the 172 different peer reviewers who have helped us to make the publications more accurate and informative. The program has been recognized twice by leading industry media organizations. Nutritional Outlook magazine presented BAP with its Best of the Industry 2016 award, and in 2019, BAP received the Editor's Award for Industry Initiative of the Year from Nutri-Ingredients USA as, and I quote, an exemplary educational resource about adulteration in the botanical supply chain. Last year, we did an informal survey of 115 BAP supporters. Based on the responses from this survey, we know that BAP publications are having an impact. Several companies replied that they have implemented new quality control measures due to BAP publications, or have revised their ingredient specifications, or have changed ingredient suppliers. Please let us know how we can improve the program and which concerns you have with regards to botanical ingredient authenticity. I encourage everyone to get involved, and thank you.
I'm Bethany. I'm on the Board of Trustees, and also I work for Megafood. We've been longtime ABC members, and we're deeply appreciative of the work that ABC does. And on a personal note, I'm so well served by just having Mark and the staff at ABC in my circle, in my orbit, in my life. And we're thrilled about the work, and we can't wait for it to continue.
Greetings from Oregon, and thank you for joining us at this annual celebration. This Botanical Adulterants Prevention Program initiative first began in 2018. I'm delighted to report that our collaborative project has now matured into a best practices template for all botanicals, all ingredients, and all components sold globally for use in dietary supplements, foods, and cosmetics. What began simply as an effort to stop the resale of adulterated botanical ingredients is now a best practices solution that fills a gap in the global current good manufacturing practice regulations regarding irreparably defective materials. So with more than 150 comments from a wide array of industry stakeholders during two public comment periods and input from international regulatory, legal, and quality experts, this deliberative effort is being prepared for final review right now. These final templates will be published and freely available to industry stakeholders via the American Botanical Council website. Our core teaching is simply this. When an ingredient or other article arrives at a receiving dock, there is only one of five possible outcomes. The very worst possible outcome is that the article is misbranded and/or adulterated. It is irreparably defective and cannot be lawfully remediated for any use anywhere, and consequently must be destroyed to prevent its re-entry into commerce. That is the condition to which our friend, fearless leader, and master of quips, Mark Blumenthal, referred when he coined the phrase, "Burn it, don't return it." Though we believe this is not a common occurrence, we do know that it sometimes happens. So our objective is very simple. As guardians at the gate, all firms, large and small, share in this responsibility to make certain that irreparably defective materials are never, ever returned into commerce. Our solution empowers all stakeholders to achieve exactly that and nothing less. And frankly, it's just the right thing to do. I'm grateful to the Botanical Adulterants Prevention Program for allowing me to lead this process, and on behalf of the American Botanical Council, invite all of you to consider financially supporting BAP so that we may continue to develop these programs to better support and protect consumer health. Thank you very much for your kind attention.
Hey everyone, Alon Sudberg, CEO of Alchemist Labs. Welcome to my laboratory. We just got some new stuff I thought I'd show you real quick. One of these guys, not quite sure what that thing does. Anyways, did you know that there's at least 400,000 plants on this planet and that the American Botanical Council spends its efforts educating the public and this industry on the 2,000 that we love and trade? That's like 0.5%. I think I speak on behalf of all of the plants and the creatures who love them. Thank you to the American Botanical Council.
It is a great pleasure and honor to introduce the 2021 ABC Vero E. Tyler Commercial Investment in Phytomedicinal Research Award. The Tyler Award is given each year to a company that exhibits a strong commitment to clinical research on the ingredients and or the products that it produces and markets. The award is named for the late Professor Vero Tyler, former Dean of the School of Pharmacy at Purdue University. A tireless advocate for rational phytotherapy, Tyler was the co-founder and first president of the American Society of Pharmacognosy. He was also one of the very first members of the ABC Board of Trustees. The 2021 Tyler Award goes to the Swedish Herbal Institute, or SHI. ABC has chosen SHI because of the company's exceptional commitment to scientific and clinical research on the therapeutic effects of several botanical ingredients, most notably andrographis and rhodiola. The company has initiated and supported over 30 clinical studies since 1995. SHI's clinical work has significantly added to the foundation for the evidence-based medicinal use of both andrographis and rhodiola, leading to effective phytotherapeutic agents in the areas of upper respiratory infections, stress-related fatigue, and mild forms of depression. I have a table that shows a scientometric profile of rhodiola rosea, which is basically a quantitative assessment and characterization of research. You can see that from 2003 to 2018, SHI has not only published the most papers on rhodiola of any organization, but also has over 40% of total citations, which is a testimony to the quality of their research. It's time to hand the screen over to the CEO of the company, Georg Wickmann. He has a background in mathematics, theoretical and general physics, and astronomy, but apparently got bored with numbers and thus founded SHI in 1975. Congratulations for all this impressive work.
I want to thank American Botanical Council and Mark Blumenthal, a friend of mine for more than 40 years, for recognizing the Swedish Herbal Institute's pioneering clinical research on adaptogens. SHI has focused on to demonstrate two issues, the mode of action and synergy between adaptogens. The main research has been on rhodiola, schisandra, elitococcus, and lately also on Leucea. We appreciate ABC's recognition of our early research in rhodiola. ABC's acknowledgement that SHI's fixed combination Kanyang based on Edicoccus and the Ku adaptogen andrographis has demonstrated a significant effect in upper respiratory tract infections. Our current focus is the application of adaptogens in COVID-related issues. We're also grateful for ABC's many years of reporting our research to the world community. This has been done via numerous summaries in ABC's HerbClip series. Your coverage of our research has increased international professional awareness on our work. I personally believe that this award is yet another milestone on the road to full acceptance of adaptogens as important health promoters in the same footing as vitamins, trace elements, and antioxidants. All of us here at SHI in Gothenburg, Sweden, thank you, ABC, for recognition and support of our many years of research in phytomedicine with this highly esteemed ABC Vero Tyler Award. Thank you.
Before we go much further into our program, we'd like to share with you some thoughts about the letter I sent to you and all ABC members on April 21st, in which ABC announced that we have hired an executive search firm to help us identify and hire a dynamic new executive director for ABC. To give you more clarity on this process, I take great pleasure in introducing to you my good friend and colleague, the chair of the board of ABC, Dr. Rick Kingston. Rick?
Hello to everyone in the ABC community. I'm pleased to be addressing you on behalf of my esteemed ABC Board of Trustees colleagues. As there are lots of exciting things happening at ABC, I wanted to provide a little background on one of the primary topics the board has been working on for some time and deals with our recently announced search for a new executive director. When I became board chair approximately 2 years ago, one of my primary objectives was to develop a succession strategy to ensure that ABC remains a vibrant source of science-based information regarding herbs and other botanicals well into the future. Mark Blumenthal, ABC's founder and executive director, wholly embraced this endeavor and has been instrumental in helping us move this initiative forward. He has endearingly referred to this as ABC's success plan, as a forward-looking roadmap for the future of ABC. The board, Mark, and I also wanted this to happen while there was no sense of urgency to take action, so that we would have the opportunity to methodically work with and support the new executive director as ABC positions itself for the future. As Mark is certainly one of a kind and one of ABC's most valuable assets, it's also been our goal to ensure that he has the opportunity and we have the good fortune to have him continue contributing to the ABC mission, something that everyone knows he is passionate about. Not only does he provide a treasure trove of institutional knowledge, but he embodies the very essence of what I think we all aspire for ABC, a trusted partner in providing timely, comprehensive, and science-based botanical information for our constituents. As for our executive director search, I am confident that a highly qualified candidate will emerge and we will enter a new chapter with this individual leading the organization to create and disseminate the types of information that is vital to unlocking the health and wellness benefits that the world of botanicals has to offer. Our new executive director will have the opportunity to shape the future of ABC with Mark and the board doing everything we can to provide support and encouragement. Mark will have the latitude to do what he does best, such as being the quintessential ABC ambassador to our constituents. And given Mark's wide expertise, the new executive director will also be able to call and rely on him as needed in a whole host of areas. I've never been more confident in the future of ABC, and I think we've taken a major step in ensuring that ABC will be there for all of you moving forward. Lastly, thank you so much for your support, because without you, there would be no ABC.
Thank you, Rick, and thank you for your great leadership as chair of the ABC Board of Trustees. As Rick has just pointed out, as every successful and properly managed nonprofit must do, ABC is taking the necessary steps to create a bright, vibrant, and successful future. And to be clear, as part of this process, I am staying with ABC. I'm not leaving. Our plan is a success plan, not a traditional succession plan. I will stay engaged with ABC and the new executive director and the board, and working in many ways related to all kinds of ABC activities as the new executive director may need and as the organization's needs might require. These include research, education, editorial issues, member and community relationships, development, visioning and planning ABC's future, and much more. And as I noted in my letter, I'm turning 75 in a few months. And although I still love working, usually 50 or more hours per week, now is the time for us to plan for ABC's continued success in serving the medicinal plant community well into the future. So, like Rick, I thank you for your support of ABC, and I thank you in advance for your continued support as we go through this exciting process.
From all your dietary supplement friends at New Chapter, a hearty thank you to Mark, Stefan, and all the amazing staff at the American Botanical Council. This has been another outstanding year for ABC, promoting exemplary botanical science, the advancement of phytomedicinal research, and your rigorous fight for the integrity of botanical ingredients.
I'm involved with the American Botanical Council because, in my opinion, it's the absolute best source and best organization for disseminating information on botanicals, providing accurate information, because as you know, there's a tremendous amount of misinformation out there. I think that the American Botanical Council does more to properly promote plant-based medicines than any entity in the world, so I'm a big fan and big supporter.
So now a special message, an invitation to anybody watching, you, who isn't right now a member of ABC, at whatever level. I invite you to come support us, come participate with us, come be part of us, an international organization that promotes science-based research and educational information for the betterment of all humankind by increasing awareness of the health benefits of herbs, medicinal plants, and beneficial fungi. Thank you. Come join us.
The American Botanical Council is pleased to honor Jerry Cott as the recipient of ABC's Champion Award for his many years of contributing his time and expertise. As a neuropsychopharmacologist, Jerry has researched the use of dietary supplements for psychiatric indications, as well as the integration of mainstream psychiatry and nutritional botanical interventions. ABC is recognizing Jerry for providing long-term academic and professional expertise as a peer reviewer of a wide range of publications that deal with psychopharmacology. Jerry has been the primary peer reviewer of many articles for ABC's flagship publication, HerbalGram, as well as a myriad of HerbClip summaries of clinical trials and research articles. Jerry has reviewed other publications for the organization as well, including chapters of the ABC Clinical Guide to Herbs. Whether fulfilling his demanding role as a senior pharmacologist for the FDA, from where he has since retired, or spending months on the island of Cyprus with questionable internet connection, Jerry has been gracious with sharing his time and knowledge as a peer reviewer for ABC for over 20 years. I have been grateful for his insights and reliability on numerous occasions throughout the years, and am delighted to present the 2021 Champion Award to him.
Many thanks to Mark Blumenthal and all the folks at ABC for this honor. Before I met Mark, I was a simple neuropsychopharmacologist at the NIMH in the early 90s. I'd started a natural products research program to try to interest the drug people in searching for kinder and gentler treatments for mental health disorders. That program is mostly screening of compounds that NIH investigators had extracted from plants or cooked up in their lab. At this point, I'd never actually met any herbalists, so I didn't know their interests. That changed at an Herbalist Guild meeting in West Virginia in 1994. Aviva Rahm invited me to talk about some work I was doing at NIH with Hypericum, otherwise known as St. John's Wort. In addition to Mark and Aviva, I met Roy Upton, Amanda McQuaid, David Winston, and others who became such good friends and colleagues. That same year, I met the famous ethnobotanist James Duke at an NIMH meeting that I had invited him to, and that guy, together with Mark, had quite an impact on my life and my wardrobe. Actually, I'm wearing one of Jim's shirts right now. So Mark recruited me as his virtual psychopharmacologist and ABC advisor on brain effects of plants, my favorite subject. I went from being Mark's mole at the NIH to insider at the FDA to retired psycho friend on the island of Cyprus. I also want to thank the warm community at ABC for accepting a non-herbalist into their confidence, even though I didn't quite have the secret handshake down right. Anyway, it's a great honor to be with you and accept this award today. Thank you.
ABC is an enormous resource for knowledge and has the talent to share this knowledge through their media outlets, HerbalGram, and more than that, they're a reliable source for resource on research, on botanicals in general. You know, it's always wonderful to see Mark Blumenthal, obviously, in his blue shirts, and every trade show would just not be the same thing. Yeah, it's Santa Claus in blue. Well, if you need somebody to look over your shoulder in what you do and give you proper advice in order to make sure that you're providing evidence and that the data that you're supplying is properly reviewed and you're doing the right thing in an ethical way in talking to your customers and your consumers, then you better talk to the people of ABC.
Good evening, and welcome to the American Botanical Council's 16th Annual Awards. This one's different this year, being virtual. It's a pleasure to be with you. We've had a long-standing relationship with ABC, and ChromaDex is pleased to sponsor all of the initiatives and efforts that Mark and everyone at ABC promotes and sets forth. Thank you for your awareness, your education, and your building of consensus across the industry. Special congratulations to all of our award winners tonight, and we appreciate the work that you do in the field. Continue that, and continued success to ABC and all of the members. From Frank Jacks, Rob Fried, and all of us at ChromaDex, have a wonderful evening.
Now it's time to present the ABC Mark Blumenthal Herbal Community Builder Award. Each year, ABC bestows this award on someone in either the herbalist community, the medicinal plant research community, or the commercial herbal products industry. Someone who has worked in such a way as to create the space and the opportunity for people with strong interests in the herbal values to come together in small or large groups and communities. This year's recipient needs no introduction to anyone who knows a little bit about the herbal community, especially the medicinal plant industry. For the past four decades, he has worked to promote the responsible growing, collection, processing, manufacturing, and marketing of herbal products in the United States and elsewhere. He is a master of important details on a wide spectrum of significant issues necessary for the success of small, medium, and large herb companies. He is clearly one of the major go-to guys in areas as diverse as good manufacturing practices, herbal nomenclature, herb safety, California's Proposition 65, among other compelling issues. He constantly writes public comments to state and federal regulatory agencies, promoting a rational and deeply informed perspective on the development of government laws, regulations, and policies. Without his strong and seemingly tireless energy and leadership, it is questionable that the herb industry in the United States would be as successful and as large as it is today. So, for these reasons, and for many, many more that are too numerous to mention in the brief amount of time I have right now, I take great pleasure in presenting the ABC Mark Blumenthal Herbal Community Builder Award for 2021 to the President of the American Herbal Products Association, the incomparable Michael McGuffin. Michael, from my heart and from all of us here at ABC, we congratulate you and thank you for your consistent efforts and many achievements that have helped to create viability, opportunities, and benefits for so many businesses and people who market, purchase, and who use beneficial herbal products. Congratulations, Michael.
Hello. I'd like to start by thanking Mark Blumenthal and ABC for this award. I really appreciate it, and I especially appreciate that I'm now in the company of the other community builders that ABC has acknowledged in prior years. I must share credit with the remarkable and talented APA staff with whom I work every day. Each of them is actively engaged in building community, not only within the APA membership, but more broadly among practicing herbalists, botanical researchers, and all those involved in the herb and natural products industry. The APA Board of Trustees also deserves to share this award. The board has for years strongly advocated for collaboration and cooperation with the other organizations who work for and represent the herbal products industry. This not only helps us get our work done more effectively, but it's clearly an opportunity to build community. I've been the APA president since 1999, and I served on the board for almost a decade prior to that. My introduction to APA came when I received a phone call from Shell Weinberg at Trout Lake Farm, inviting me to consider filling a vacancy on the APA board. But I was running a small herb business at the time, and I told Shell, "I'm just too busy." I'm never going to forget his response. Shell said, "We're all too busy, Michael, but it's your turn." And somehow that message resonated with me. So let me leave you with this. Maybe it's your turn to broaden your focus from wherever you now spend your days, professionally or personally, and try to build community in whatever corner of the world you find yourself. And I'll see you there. Thank you, and thanks again to ABC.
As you know, ABC is a nonprofit organization, and we have a whole range of research and educational activities. These activities are possible because of members like you. So I want to thank all of you who are members of ABC at whatever level, particularly our sponsor members from industry, as well as the thousands of medicinal plant chemists, pharmacognosists, botanists, health professionals, herbalists, naturopaths, etc., dietitians, pharmacists, in 80 countries around the world who support the unique nonprofit research and educational activities, mission, publications, and programs of ABC. Without you, there is no ABC. So on behalf of all of us at ABC, the staff, the Board of Trustees, and the Advisory Board and Director Circle, and all of the contractors at ABC, I thank you for your grateful support.